So now we'll see how to configure the TV for the first time. And you can see after pairing the remote, it is now showing welcome on the screen, and this is the remote we are holding, and the language setup is visible. So we need to select the language first. So there is two different method to configure this TV, like it is mentioned in the screen, quickly set up your TV with your Android phone. So we are going to configure this phone using Android phone, and that should be connected with the internet connectivity, and that should have a Google account. Okay, so we'll configure the phone right now. And I have got a phone with me right now. It's a OnePlus device, you can see. So, okay, Google. See, this voice assistant is working. And now we'll press continue on the TV. So you can see the things are mentioned very clearly on the TV screen. First, second and third step you have to follow. First step, on your Android phone, open the pre-installed app Google, type or say OK Google to set up my device, and tap OnePlus, then you need to enter the particular code. So I have already opened the voice assistant on my device, you can see over here, and now we'll configure the TV. Set up my device. So see, in the phone getting started option is visible. This device is now searching for device. So it is now showing connecting. See, the code is visible on my TV as well as on my device. So now I need to verify the code. So I'll click on next option. So it is connected now. So the TV will now connect with the device or with your mobile, and it will quickly finish the setup. Okay, so now you can see the device. In the device, it is clearly visible. Visible to select the Wi-Fi account, and you need to select that. After that, it is mentioning like choose an account, which Google account you want to select. The account is already exist on my phone, so I'll select this account. Yeah. It is asking now copy to your new device. So copy your Google accounts and restore your Google backup if available. So you can do that. You can click on next. And now it will copy the details to your TV. And it will install and it will accept the account on your TV as well. Okay. So now you can see on the phone. You need to enter your password. So you can see now the sign-in is completed in the device also, and it is showing like almost done. So see, TV is visible with a new screen, and you need to now click on accept use the remote. Yes, you can turn on your location. Yes, you need to click on yes. And definitely Google Assistant will be available with this TV. Continue. Now we can turn on this things also. Google Assistant ko allow kar do. And yeah, now it is prompting for some additional application. So we can select this application and it will get installed. Otherwise you can skip this particular step. Uncheck karo usko. Yes, continue, and you can click on continue. So see, this TV is almost ready and the setup is done. We can click the navigation button on the remote and we can click it. Yeah, once again, next. So we have a OnePlus button on the remote that is specifically having some different features. We'll be explaining the feature in the coming video. So now it is a terms and service, you can accept that. And definitely, this is the information from OnePlus. You can definitely accept that or you can reject that also. If you have any OnePlus account, you can sign in over here. Otherwise, you can skip. So see, the TV is now configured and it is ready for your use. Now we can select any application from the home screen, and different options are visible. You can even use your Google Assistant to search something, and other application, Google, and different things are available. Okay, so enjoy.